Hi everyone, I am Anil Kumar, motivational speaker. Today I am going to talk about how to solve problems in 3-year LLB and 5-year LLB of KSLU, Karnataka State Law University, Hubli. Many of the students have been requested to me to how to solve the problems in any of law exams. So today I am going to talk about that. So it is very easy to solve problems. If you know thoroughly, properly the content, means theme of the subject or theme of the law, and if you have studied properly that law or any kind of concept, you can able to solve very easily. If you doesn't have read the law or concept of any subject, you cannot able to solve the problem. So that is the reason I am always advising, please study, not for examination point, but gain your knowledge, so that you can have, you can very easily, you can able to solve. Today I will solve two kind of problems in labor law. So I have opted for two questions, how to solve the problem. So earlier I told, it is very easy if you know the content, if you know the law, if you know the sections, subsections, definitely you can able to solve. So it is very, very important that you can get very good marks in problem solving. So if you know the content, if you know the concept, if you know the law, if you know the section, subsection, you can easily score. So many people nowadays, they are telling, many students, they are telling to me, sir, 3 units is enough to study, so that we'll have a 10 marks questions of 10, so that 5 we can write it very easily. But my advice is to please study all the units. So problems will come in all units. So if you study all units, you can able to solve very easily. I can show one demo today. Here the question which are underlined in the yellow. Just go through. Once again, I will read. For your reference only, I made a highlighter. This is the question. Earlier, it was asking for 10 marks, but now it is 6 marks. They will be asked for any problems in any law. So I will explain how to write it. So 35 women are employed in Mithili Industries. Since only 2 women workers were having children below 5 years of age, the manager of the industry refuses to provide crèche for the children. Is the refusal correct? Do you mean that this is the refusal is correct? According to my view, it is not correct. Why? Because you take Factories Act 1948. What Factories Act 1948 says, for any woman employees engaged in any industry, we should need to provide a crèche facility. So here 35 women are working. So 35 women are working means that employer has to provide a crèche facility in that industry. So one point is, you write it here. First is introduction. You write introduction. In introduction, Factories Act 1948, crèche, where it is come crèche. So where it is come means chapter 5 in the welfare, it is coming crèche. You have to mention in the introduction, Factories Act 1948 tells about the crèche facility. We need to provide crèche facility. If we any engage of 30 women employees, we have to provide a crèche facility. So here the 35 women ordinarily employed means we have to give crèche minimum 30 employees employed in any organization. So one question here, 35 women are employed, so that in Mithili industries, so they are eligible for CREACH. You have to write in the introduction that you have to, whichever I have told, you have to make in introduction. Is the refusal is correct? You make it off. Is the refusal is correct? It's not correct. Why it is not correct? In the theme you have to write, as per Factories Act 1948, chapter number 5, welfare provides CREACH facility. Any engaged women employees in any organization, we have to provide CREACH. So here, in one more question is there. Below 5 years of age, what CREACH says, if any children not more than 6 years, they are eligible for to avail the CREACH facility. Here the law says below 6 years, not above 6 years, below 6 years, any male or female child is eligible to occupy in that CREACH facility. So what you write to do is, here you have to write, as per Factories Act 1948, chapter number 5, welfare, CREACH is a mandatory to provide an organization of ordinarily employed of 30 women employees, and as per the act, these children are below 5 years, two children who are below 5 years, hence CREACH is mandatory to provide any of the employer. So this statement is not correct, so that you can complete it. Again, you have to make conclusion, one conclusion. You see, some of the people are there, they know answer. They write, see, this is problem, no? Whatever, only, is there refusal is correct? No, not correct. Not correct, and they have left like that. So you will get only 1 mark for that. So if you explain with chapter, section or subsection, and where it is come, what is the provisions under this act, if you write all those things, and you have to make one small conclusion, so that in conclusion, so that is the reason this statement is not correct due to this is falls under Factories Act 1948. Minimum 30 women employees ordinarily employed means we have to provide the CREACH facility. In the CREACH facility, CREACH rule says below 6 years of age of any female or male children to be taking care of in this CREACH. So like that, if you write like that in your own way, definitely you will get 6 out of 6. No chance to reduce your marks. This is one. One more example I will show you. Here you can able to see it now. Whichever yellow mark highlighted, you have to see. Here what this is, a workman died due to an accident while performing the duty of an employer. Subsequently, it had been proved that at the time of the accident, the workman was under the influence of intoxication. Whether employer is liable to pay compensation? Here, which act it belongs to? You have to think it. Immediately you can come to know, this is Employees Compensation Act 1923. What Employees Compensation Act 1923 says, you have to mention briefly in introduction. Then after, you have to statement whether it is true or not, you have to make the statement in another line. Whether employer is liable to pay compensation, according to me, no, the employer is not liable to pay for this compensation. Why? You have to make it next line, why the employer is not liable to pay the compensation. What Compensation Act 1923 says, Section 3 of Employees Compensation Act says employer non-liability for payment of compensation. Some of the exemption this act has been provided. So in that exemption, this point will belongs to. How it is belongs to? As per Section 3 of Subsection 1 of the Employees Compensation Act 1923, the employer is not liable to pay compensation. Why he is not liable to pay the compensation? Here, point have been mentioned in the Act saying that the employee having at the time of the accident is under the influence of drink or drugs. If he has taken drink or drugs, if he has taken means he is not, if he died is due to his negligency and due to he has taken drunk of drugs or intoxication, so he is not liable to pay for the compensation. You see, every law we need to follow. If not follow the law, we have to pay or we have to get penalties from the acts. So it is very important that we have to think which law it belongs to and what section says. If you, that is the reason I am telling always to you all, please study the content of subject, some content of the law, each and everything you should know, then only you can able to write very easily. Here also introduction you have to write 2 to 3 lines, then after whether it is right or not, you have to mention whether it is true or not, you have to mention the subject, reason for where it is comes, section, subsection, where it is comes, and conclusion also you have to write. In one page you can complete it, the any kind of problem. So if you write one page all those things whichever told that statements, so you will get aram se, you can get 6 marks. It takes only 5 to 6 minutes to write, not more than 10 minutes, so you can score very good. I hope these two examples will going to help you to get your score in LLB. So many of the students have requested to do this. So today I have done it. So I hope this video will be going to helpful to you. Please do subscribe my channel Anil Kumar KT so that you will get very good videos on LLB, motivation and human resource management. Thank you.